Hi friends, how are you? In this video, we are going to learn about the dangerous area of the face. Dangerous area of the face. The facial vein and its communications are divided of walls in the lumens. The facial vein and its communications are divided of walls in the lumens. Since the facial vein rests directly on the muscle of facial expression, the movements of these muscles may facilitate the spread of septic emboli from infected area of the lower part of the nose and upper lip and adjoining parts of the cheek in retrograde direction through deep facial vein, pterygoid venous plexus and emissary vein into the cavernous sinus, leading to meningitis and cavernous sinus thrombosis. For this reason, this portion of the face is called dangerous area of the face. The facial vein and its communications are divided of walls in the lumens. Since the facial vein rests directly on the muscles of facial expression, the movement of these muscles may facilitate the spread of septic emboli from infected area of the lower part of the nose, upper lip and adjoining part of the cheek in retrograde direction through deep facial vein, pterygoid venous plexus and emissary vein into the cavernous sinus. It leads to the meningitis and cavernous sinus thrombosis. For this reason, this portion of the face is called dangerous area of the face. Coming to the figure. Lower part of the nose, upper lip and somewhat cheeks. The side here. This area of the cheek, we call this as dangerous area of the face because the infections may reach the cavernous sinus through this area by deep facial vein, pterygoid venous plexus and emissary veins into the cavernous sinus and leads to meningitis as well as cavernous sinus thrombosis. Okay. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.